Namaskar. Welcome in the studio of NIOS. Myself, Dr. Preeti Pandey, and today we are going to know school as a resource center. Do you know a school is the biggest resource center, we can say? How we can say that school is the biggest resource center? For this, we should know first what is actually a resource center. A resource center is an organized collection of books, magazines, and non-book materials. These days, we have digital as well as non-digital collections also. So, school represents all these things. Schools have books, magazines, and non-book materials also, digital materials also. So, according to me, and according to everybody, school is the biggest resource center, we can say. What comes into the school? As we are talking about the books, the first comes library. What is a library? See here, the library is of a middle school. A school library or a school library media center is a library within a school where students, staff, and often parents have access to a variety of resources. The goal of the school library media center is to ensure that all members of the school community have equitable access to books and reading, to informations, and to information technology. Means, what is library actually? Library is the collection of the books as well as the digital material. These days, we are having CDs, we can access computers also here, but more we are having the books, magazines, storybooks, and many more things to read. Here, the teacher can go and study, the student can go and study, and even the parents can also access to the library. So this is the biggest resource. Whatever you want to study, whatever you want to learn, you can go and spend time in the library whenever you are free. And we are having periods also allotted to the teachers and students to use this resource. Next one is computer lab. These days we are having compulsorily computer lab in each and every school. The government is emphasizing on use of computers, and our Prime Minister is going to make Digital India. So well equipped with the computer lab these days. In cities, I'm not talking about the village, because there we don't have even electricity. So how can we talk about the computer lab? But computer lab is the biggest resource center. We are connected globally here. A computer lab is a space which provides computer services to a defined community. Computer labs are typically provided by libraries to the public, by academicians, institutions to students who attend the institution, or by other institution to the public or to person affiliated with that institution. Means teacher can access the computer lab, the student can go and access the computer, internet facilities, and even the parents when they are free, or the person who are affiliated to the institution can go and make use of the computers and internet facilities there. And we can be connected to the whole world by the computers. We can see the tsunami waves, we can see the snowfall, we can see the desert areas and everything. This is the biggest resource, you can say, because we can learn. We have so many lectures on YouTube, we are having so many chapters, demonstrations on YouTube. So computer is a great resource for everybody, and it is available in the school, and we don't have to even pay the internet charges also. You can use the computer lab. Teachers can also use, students can also use. So school is the biggest resource center, you can say. Now there are science labs. Since we are talking about the EVS, or we are talking about the maths, or whatever is there, subjects are there. We have science labs there which are well equipped, provides space and material to student teachers for hands-on experience with science learning material. In the science lab, we can learn by doing. Means learning by doing is done there. We get first-hand experience in our science lab. Science lab provides the teacher educators and student teachers material and equipment for demonstration, experimentation, and other related activities. Means I am teaching EVS and I want to demonstrate some topic. Say I want to show my students that water is a universal solvent. So what can I do? I can go to the lab, take my children to the lab, or I can also bring the things from the lab and demonstrate the experiment to my students. What does Science Lab do? Science Lab also provide opportunities to teacher educators to demonstrate process skills. It is a skill actually. Doing experimentation is a skill. For example, sometimes we are not able to see the ring of copper in the test tube. But the person who is skilled, he will be able to form the skill. We all are using the same reagents, but we are not able to show the rings. Then how these rings can be shown? This is a skill. And Science Lab develops that skill. So it is also one of the resource center which is available in our school. Next one is Maths Lab. These are the basic subjects. What does Maths Lab do? It provides space and material to student teachers for hands-on experience with mathematics learning material. As in Science Lab, we go through with the science topics. In Maths Lab, we go with the maths topic. It also provides the teacher educators and student teachers material, equipments for demonstration and other related activities. For example, we are talking about the D.El.Ed. You are going to be a pupil teacher first. Then you can take the equipments from our lab and show to your students. And being a teacher educator, I can use that equipments to show how you are going to demonstrate a particular chapter or how you are going to demonstrate a particular topic. It also provides opportunity to teacher educators to demonstrate processes. As I told you that I can also use the equipments to show you how the chapter is taught by using these skills or how we can use Maths Lab. Previously it was not there, but nowadays it is mandatory in schools to have Maths Lab also. So they are a good resource center for teaching maths. Now it is also mandatory these days to have audiovisual or multimedia room. Though we have come to the smart board, means from blackboard to green board to whiteboard and whiteboard to smart board, we have completed our journey. But all schools are not able to afford smart board in each and every classroom. So at least they are having one room which are well equipped with the smart boards. And the students are supposed to see and relish the multimedia effects there. What does this multimedia room does? It provides a place equipped with necessary resources to stimulate thinking, leading to development of innovative teaching learning material. One of my kids said, ma'am, yesterday I saw the movie of Salman Khan's Sultan, and it was so much motivating. So in audiovisual room, some movies, some documentary films are shown which make the child sensitive, which inspire the child to be like that. For example, movie of Milkha Singh, it can be shown. And so many things are there. Movie of dinosaur, we can say how the dinosaur evaluated and how they were come to an extinct. We can show that they have been extincted from the earth. So all these objectives can be achieved from this multimedia room, and students learn a lot. As we all know that by listening we forget, but by seeing we learn a lot, and by listening and seeing we learn more and more. So these rooms are a good resource center which we can say we can retain our learning, and our students enjoy in multimedia room. The next lab is art and craft. It is also the important feature of every school here. What is Art and Craft Lab? Art and Craft Lab is a place where learners can express their artistic view and can develop and show their imagination power. Students can also build a personality of positive thinking with proper attitude. This lab is a place of experiments with creativity. Of course, in Science Lab, we develop the scientific attitude. In Maths Lab, we develop the mathematical attitude. And here in Art and Craft Lab, we develop our creativity. Creativity is very necessary, and a person with scientific attitude and creativity and a good aptitude can do lot of things. So these all labs and centers are a resource for us. We can develop, we can make best out of waste. It develops our imagination power. Teacher are making so many things from waste. You can reuse, recycle the things. And here in art and craft lab, we learn all these things, how to do positive things with the waste which we are throwing in our home. We can use it, and it is a biggest resource center. Next is a sports club. Sports club is also a resource center. In sports club, we learn how to play, we learn rules and regulations, we learn to be fit, and many more things we learn from the sports club. Sports, why is sports necessary? Sports is necessary because healthy body has healthy mind. So by sports club, we learn to be fit, we learn to be healthy, we learn different rules of games, we learn struggle of players. Means I say that Michael Phelps is a very good swimmer. He is not swimmer by birth. He has done a lot of struggle. Milkha Singh is a very good athlete. But it's not so. He has done a lot of struggle. So we can inculcate that thought that after struggling, they have achieved this goal. So you should be also involved in these type of struggles. We can develop our personality. Personality of a kids developed by sports. They develop team spirit and they develop cooperation. So many things we learn from sports. We learn to do yoga and meditations. Here in schools, we learn yoga and meditation, and yoga is so much necessary for these days for stress management. Everybody is having stress, a student, teacher. We learn to meditate. We build our physical and mental health. So what sports club is giving to us? It is actually building our physical and mental health. Now, school premises. We all have school premises and we learn a lot from school premises. So it is also a resource center, and it is since in our school. So school is the biggest resource center, we can say. We learn, sometimes we clean our garden. So we are learning that we should always live in a clean and hygiene place. See, we are learning to how to manage our waste. Waste management is done. So we learn a lot from school premises. Nature is the biggest resource, you all know. So the school premises is very natural and we learn naturally. We learn so many things informally. Informally means we are seeing that the person is throwing the garbage in the dustbin. We learn it from seeing only, informally. Nobody is teaching us. We learn so many things by observing. We observe our teachers, that how they are doing the things, how dedicated they are. So we learn things by observing. We learn so many things by analyzing, and we analyze the things that this teacher is very good. This teacher does her work very nicely and she is very managed, or he is very managed, he is very fit, she is very fit. So we learn from the observation, we learn informally and analyzing, and these we all learn from our school premises. Then assemblies and celebrations, they are very important source of learning, and we all get this. Assemblies are done in school only, not at home. Celebrations, so many celebrations are done in the school. Annual celebration is there, sports day celebration is there. And these days we are celebrating Raksha Bandhan festival. We are celebrating Diwali. Now New Year is coming. So there school has organized a party, New Year party for kids. In January, they will organize the kite flying competition. So we are learning about our festivals, our culture. In assembly, we do yoga. In assembly, we do prayers. In assembly, we have motivational thoughts. Teachers tell us motivational thoughts. These all are learning experiences. And we are learning from assembly and celebration, which is in school. So school is the biggest learning resource. In assembly, we develop our personality and attitude. We become fit. We pray to God in the morning that thank you, God, for making us fit, for making us to study, making us to read. Motivational thoughts and speech develop insight amongst us, amongst all of us. We develop an insight when we listen some motivational thought, which is practiced in our assembly sessions. Different type of celebrations develop patriotic feelings and sustain our culture. As I told you, I gave you the example that we are having kite flying competitions. And then we are celebrating 26th January, we are celebrating 15th of August, we are celebrating 2nd October as a Swachh Bharat mission. So we are developing the patriotic feeling. So many people have died for the sake of our country. We learn all these things. We develop that sentiments that we have not achieved the independence and free. Too much of a struggle we have done. So a student develop the sensitivity towards that these peoples, and we are able to sustain our culture, and we all learn these things in our assembly sessions as well as in celebrations. We develop in spiritual context. Actually, we develop in spiritual context because we learn to respect people. We learn to respect our parents. We learn to respect our teachers, and we are able to sustain our culture. So we develop in a spiritual context. Now, human resources are there in school. Our authorities, our teachers, our students, staff and helpers, all are human resource for us. And these all people are available in the school. If we want to, sometimes our principal give a lecture. That lecture is very much beneficial for all of us, for teachers, for students. Similarly, teaches us so many things in the classroom. So we are learning directly from our teachers, informally as well as formally. And teachers also learn from students. Some students are so bright, they teach their teachers even. So these are the human resource which we are getting in the school, and we are learning from them. Then there are our staff members. We learn informally from them. We learn formally from them because we are not perfect. I know something better, but she knows something more better than me. So I can learn from her. Our helpers, we learn how to clean the things, how to keep ourselves clean and keep the surrounding clean, how to be polite. Everything we learn from all of these people in the school. So these are also the resources for us. Now, I would like to compile what we have studied in this session. We have studied that school is the biggest resource for an individual. And this can be also proved. What we are having school chalo abhiyan. Why it is so? Because it is the biggest source of learning. So it is known as the biggest resource center on this earth. Everybody is going to school and everybody is forced to go to school because that is the biggest resource center. For example, we are having so many things on our school. As we discussed earlier, we are having library, we are having computer lab, we are having science lab, we are having maths lab, we are having sports club. These days we are having different types of clubs also in schools. We are having jest club, means in jest club we are the school is having the club in which special need children are coming. And they are involved in some creative work so that they may develop the confidence. So school is working as the biggest resource center for them also even. Not for the normal children. Children with the special needs are also being very much influenced by school. Previously, these type of children were not imbibed in the school. These days, we have started inclusive education. And previously, we don't include them in our regular schools, but these days we are including them also in our schools, and we are promoting them, we are motivating them to learn the things, we are making different papers for them. So school is working a lot, and it is the biggest resource center. A person who is not going to school is deprived from so many things, so many things. In free period we can play, we learn by playing also. We learn how to cooperate. We develop the power of tolerance because everybody is not equal. Few children also hurt us, and few say some abusive words. Few say something else to us. Few throw something. So we develop a tolerance power also. As I told you, we develop in a spiritual context. In school, we are developing in a perfect personality. Our versatile development is done in the school. So school is the biggest resource center, we can say. And see, at one place we are getting so many things. Is there any other place where we are getting so many things? If you want to access to computer, we have to go to cyber cafe. if you want to go to read some storybooks, some novels, or anything else related to our content, some extra knowledge, we have to buy the book, or we have to go some other library. But in school, what you are getting? You are getting library also. You are getting computer lab also. If you want to learn something important, you want to do some experiments in science, where to go? Whether you will buy all the equipments? No, not at all. But school is providing you all these things. School is providing you the equipments. School is well equipped with all your facilities. You want, how much we become happy by seeing different types of model and projects made by us. We develop things, so many things, and it is all made by us. We all develop our school. We develop our own resource center. And see, it is only one platform where we are getting so many things. We don't have to go here and there to access all these things. Then assembly is there, celebrations are there. In celebrations, we learn the culture of the Bengali people also. We learn the culture of the South Indians. We learn the culture of the North Indians. We learn the culture of the East. Say, we can say East and West India is the best. The classroom is the total of whole country. And we learn so many things from our peer groups, human resource. We learn from our classmates. We learn from our friends. We learn from our teachers. We learn from our directors. We learn from our principal ma'am. And we learn from our helpers also. From everybody we learn. And where we get all these peoples, we all get under one platform, under one roof, you can say, that we are getting all these things, all the resources, all the authorities, all the things we are getting in this only, on one roof only. We are having one platform where we can access to everything, everything. Whatever you want, you can get in the school. You can play, you can weep, you can cry, you can do everything. You can learn so many things in the school. So, who are deprived from the school, I can say they are very unfortunate. And I am enough fortunate to be always in a good school. And I have used all the resources of my school, and I hope you will also love school. You will also use all the resources of your school, and when you will come in college, you will miss your school life. So enjoy up to the utmost joy your school. Have a nice day, and we will meet in the next session. Till then, bye, and thanks a lot.